Hey there, it's Tony with Foggy1gaming, coming at you with a special episode. We are going to be talking about survivability on the battlefield. Is this happening to you way too often? Are you getting hammered out of existence by the red team way too quickly? You're not making it to the end of the match. You're not getting the beacons. You're not getting the damage infliction that you wanted, or the bot takedowns that you've been really wanting to rack up. Well, we're going to talk about that today. I am going to be covering my top 7 tips on how to survive on the battlefield. And if you practice these tips, you will last longer, you will go out there and get more beacons, you're gonna pound on more bots, and your scores are gonna go up. So you know what? Let's get over into it, let's get into the action, let's get into my tips on how to survive on the battlefield. Alrighty guys, let's start off with the number one tip I can give any player on the battlefield. Use concealment and cover. Use the structures around you to give you protection, to give you positions of safety where one, you can launch devastating attacks from, and two, retreat to and make plans to how you're going to counterpunch or counter move against the enemy when they're making advancements or retreats on the battlefield. You want to make sure that you're using structure so that it can give you protection from, like, I'm getting behind cover to get away from that splash damage from the Kumio. But now I'm also going to use that same structure now to come out and launch a counterattack on him and then retreat back behind safety again. That's using concealment and cover. You're going to use this early on in the game when you have bots that, you know, you don't have a lot of bells and whistles to them. They don't have shields. They don't have anything. You're going to have to survive by your sheer wits. And that's why I'm out here with the Gareth, because the Gareth has a little shield to it. But you know what? It really, really is a squishy bot here. And you know what? It really, really makes you focus on good tactics. Now, I'm going to use these little storage containers here as little pods of safety, little pods of concealment and cover. And I'm going to launch some attacks on some bots down the battlefield here. And you can see there's some decent bots out there with a lot of firepower, way more than I have with the Gareth. And here's a nice bot right here. We're going to take, I believe this is a, there's a Fury down there. Here we go. And boom, double takedown. Launching off, you know, counterattacks from behind these protective barriers is a huge thing. Now, let's talk a little bit about the second tip I can give you guys on the battlefield. Always keep moving. Everyone knows by common sense, a moving target is harder to hit than a stationary one. And this is very true, especially if you deal with vortexes and with aphids. If you're moving, it does way less damage to you. But now, keeping moving means your enemy cannot make plans to go after you. And you want to keep your movements, you know, very erratic. You want to make sure it's just not straight lines. You want to go zigging and zagging from point A to point B. You want to go from position of safety to position of safety. And then when you have the opportunity, like here, I'm coming up over the top of this little lip here. I'm going to hit the invader, and I'm going to pull back. I'm going to keep moving. And there are some bots down the field. I'm going to throw a little damage fire down there with my pin and Tolumbus combo here. And we're just going to keep hopping along here. And here we see there is an Inquisitor right there. Here we go. This bot's going to jump up. We're going to take an airborne opportunity here. Boom! Takedown. Keep moving. The more you move, the more likely it is also that you're going to put yourself in a position where you could probably do a takedown. Like this bot right here is just sitting there. I don't have the firepower to take him down one fell swoop, but I can do some damage to him and keep moving. If you keep moving, you put yourself in the opportunistic position to be able to do some damage. Now, of course, when you keep moving, you're using your concealment and cover. You've also got to set up that for that moment when you lose tactical advantage. And that sets you up for tip number 3. Know when to retreat. If you've lost the tactical advantage, like I have here with this Spectre, time to get out of here, time to live to fight another day. And that is something you need to know on the battlefield. There's a point where you press your advantage, and there's a point where you retreat. Now, here also is the point where you also have to look for opportunities. When you're moving, doing everything right, opportunities are going to present themselves. Like right there on that bot that was behind the cover there. I was able to hit him with the aphids from my Raven there. And as I went to a position of safety, this other bot comes wandering out, and boom, I get a second takedown. I'm looking for opportunities. Always scanning the horizon, looking for those chances to do extra damage or take a bot down, or grab a beacon for that matter. And there is a point in the match where you're going to want to play aggressively. If you play too passively or too defensively, you're going to lose the match. So if you play aggressively, one, it sets the tone. It makes your enemies think, what the heck am I dealing with? What kind of lunatic is on the battlefield? And sometimes that's a good thing. So sometimes you want to press that advantage and you want to be aggressive. Just like I went over the top and dropped in on that Spectre right there. Sometimes it's very good to be aggressive. Now, you want to use your tools available. Like I'm using the deployment screen here, and you can see I'm watching the red team and I'm looking at where they're going. Use the tools that the game gives you and use that, especially if you know where the troop movements are going. That's going to allow you to get in front of them so you're not chasing them or putting yourself in a position where you get hammered on. Now, number seven is huge. Situational awareness. Know what's going on around you and go after everything that you can and put it all together. All right, with that, let's hop over into the hangar and let's finish up this episode for you guys. Alrighty guys, that's my top seven tips on how to survive on the battlefield. You practice those tips, you're gonna survive longer, you're gonna seize more beacons, you're gonna take more bots down, and you're gonna inflict more damage out on the battlefield, no matter what league you're in and no matter what hangar you're playing with. So make sure you get out there and practice those seven fundamental tips to have a great time out there playing on the field. Alrighty guys, that's going to be a wrap for me here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you liked it, make sure to give it a thumbs up to let Pixonic know that this is a good video. And of course, if you guys want to come over and check out my channel, feel free to come on over, check things out, and see the action that's going on over at Foggy1gaming. Alrighty guys, I'm out of here. Keep your bots on the field, and I'll catch you on the server sometime.